Hey internet, it's Jessica, and so this is kind of weird. This video is of my first Let's Play on this channel that I made back in, I think it was August of 2015, I don't remember. But I actually ended up deleting the entire Let's Play of Game of Thrones Telltale's version, because there was a copyright scare that I had to deal with a few months ago, and I kind of panicked, and then I ended up deleting a bunch of old videos, which I didn't really need to do, so that was kind of my mistake. But I decided to re-upload them to the channel because I asked you guys, and a bunch of you said that I should re-upload them because you wanted to see them. So I hope you enjoy this very cringy, terrible Let's Play, because it's so bad. Like, it's really bad. Even like the audio mixing is so bad, sometimes you can barely hear me because the audio from the game like overpowers my voice. Yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this first Let's Play of my channel. This is the Let's Play that started my channel, and fittingly I played Telltale's Game of Thrones, which is an amazing game, and I'm a huge fan of A Song of Ice and Fire and the TV show Game of Thrones. So I hope you guys enjoy this, and I'm very sorry if you cringe a lot, but yeah, I'm gonna be re-uploading a bunch of the episodes for Game of Thrones, but in one video, just to condense it, and yeah, I'd really appreciate if you guys, you know, like the video, or even comment on it, and tell, you know, it's nice to see how far I've came, you know, from this first video to my Let's Plays now. I'm not... At least I hope I'm not that cringy anymore. But anyway, enjoy the cringe fest. Bye, guys. Hey, internet. It's Jessica. So, welcome to my gaming channel. This is the first series that I'm going to be playing. It's Game of Thrones by Telltale Games. I just want to let everybody know that I've played episode 1 through 4 already, so I know what's going to happen there. But I haven't played the newest episode, episode 5. Also, I want to give a spoiler warning for anybody who hasn't caught up with the show or with the TV. I mean, with the books, whoops. you should, if you don't want spoilers, you should really avoid this. But, I just wanted to record my choices from episode 1 to 4 so you guys can see what I've been doing. And, yeah. Let's start. It's been a while since I played the first episode, so I don't really remember like the small details and whatever, but major events. I know what's gonna happen, and it is Game of Thrones, so. Also, if I sound a little bit ick, it's because I'm sick. I'm just getting over a cold, so sorry about that. For thousands of years, House Forrester have been loyal bannermen to House Stark. In the darkest reaches of the Wolveswood, they have harvested the rare ironwood trees. Now the North has been ripped apart by war and rival houses, to seek claim over Forrester's ironwood for themselves. And the fate of House Forrester hangs in the balance. Alright, for people who don't know, episode 1 actually starts in an episode from season 3 of the show, the Red Wedding episode. Which is a traumatizing episode, I must say. The first time that I saw the Red Wedding episodes, oh my god, I was so shocked. I was sitting there for 5 minutes with my mouth open. It was terrible.
You'd think he'd done it himself the way he tells it. Lord Forrester's sword won't clean itself, you know.
Alright, so this is us, Garrett Tuttle. We are the squire for Lord Forrester. So, let's
make sure it's spotless
sword.
This time. Lord Forrester won't be happy with blood and brains all over it.
I have to say, out of all the houses of Game of Thrones, I think my favorite one would have to be House Stark. I know that.
I say that as a friend.
They have bad luck, but yeah, I really like the Starks.
Why not? They don't give swords like that to pig farms.
But my favorite character would have to be Daenerys Targaryen. And favorite male character is Jon Snow.
He was nowhere near the King's Slayer at Whispering Wood. He was so drunk he barely made it out of his tent.
that episode of the final episode of last season.
Not really.
where Jon Snow gets stabbed. Oh my god, I was screaming at my TV that night. I was watching it at like 2 o'clock in the morning, and I screamed so loud. It's terrible. I don't believe he's dead, by the way. There's no way. Because, I hope they go this way about it in, from the books, that he logs into ghosts, because it seems like it's going to that way. Questioning Narin's honor. There's no way he's dead. I don't believe it. His storyline is too important.
Get your liege lord some wine.
Go on.
Okay. Job.
Right, thanks. You're welcome.
You know, Bond's kind of a dick.
Thank you, Garrett. I'll do it. Norrin's family has faithfully served House Forrester for centuries.
The one thing, I guess is a good thing and a bad thing about northern men, or the northern houses of Westeros, is they're very loyal and honorable, especially to their own kind and stuff, but that can get you killed. Example, Ned Stark, the first season. Can I just say that I you know, without reading the books, because I only read the 2 books, I just finished the second one, and I only started reading the books, like, last year.
Rob Stark, the king in the north.
Without knowing anything about
we march on Casterly Rock.
The show or the story, I automatically knew Ned Stark was gonna die, because it's played by Sean Bean. Like, he dies from like every role he has.
The gods are favorites. Onward to Casterly Rock.
This is what's supposed to happen.
Iron from ice.
Is the words of House Forrester.
Got it.
Still upsetting. Yes, I can't believe it.
I need you.
Rob died.
For Roderick,
as his father.
He died so brutally too.
I could not be more
terrible.
Proud of the man he's become. On a night like this, men find false courage at the bottom of their cups. I'd rather he were here.
Yes, my lord.
There's also the question of what's to be done with you.
It's been on my mind for a while now.
Something must be done.
With me, my lord.
I feel like, well, I mean, like I said before, the northern houses are very honorable and loyal. Lord Forrester seems someone who would be like Ned Stark.
What can I offer you?
Honor the house.
To bring honor to House Forrester, my lord.
If I was to be living in Westeros at all, I believe I'd be living in the north. Just because, I mean, I hate winter, don't get me wrong, so I hate,
it would be an honor
hate snow,
but by
the way that their people are, they're very,
not as a squire,
I don't know,
but as the equal,
I would like
of any
to live among
who
them instead of like King's
Forrester.
Landing or whatever.
It's well,
the Lannisters are terrible.
Your hard work has paid off.
Thank you, my lord.
I don't want to be a dick.
I promise.
I played as a dick on my other playthrough, and that's some interesting dialogue.
You're celebrating tonight. I wouldn't want the other squires to feel discouraged.
Yes, my lord.
Now go and find Roderick if you can.
I will, my lord. Thank you.
Bloody hell.
Squire, fetch us more wine.
Can you give me a hand?
I don't want to, like, boast about Garrett getting promoted, so
yeah,
I'll help you, even though you're an ass.
I have been a squire longer than you, so I outrank you. You should help me.
Look at him. Such a dick.
Fetch more wine. Grab my armor. Clean my boots.
Oh my goodness, Bowen, stop complaining. He whines so much.
Let him fetch his own wine for once.
Could be worse.
Drunk, a liar, and an arrogant prick. You'd better watch your tongue, Bowen. It could be much worse.
What the fuck do you know about it? Nothing is worse than Norin.
What do you mean, the fuck do you know? We're squire too, you dick.
No expectations. If I'd grown up covered in pig shit, trouble and slop, well, maybe I'd think saddling his horse was the greatest honor in the Seven Kingdoms.
Wow.
I suppose this beats pig farming. But not by much. Just
shut
your mouth.
Up.
It's the truth. It's not like I'm making it up.
Such a dick.
All I'm saying is, at this rate, we'll never be more than this, which is nothing. The lowest of the low. For all I
maybe
know,
for you.
We could be squires for life.
and wine around that fucking wedding. What a waste of fucking time.
I'm sick of listening to your whine. With that attitude, you'll never be more than this.
Easy for you to say. Maybe if my uncle were Castle, then I'd feel different.
Who my uncle is has nothing to do with it.
I really love Telltale's game series. They do a really good job adapting from the show. Oh no. Oh, it's a red wedding. And Waldifrain, you son of a bitch.
Take your time. You lot.
I feel like if Rob actually listened to Catelyn Stark about her telling him not to seek aid from Waldifrain or having anything to deal with him, they would still be alive. That's how I wish it went down, but nope. You can see, like, I just finished reading the second book, like I said, and you can tell from Catelyn's point of view in her chapters, she knows, like, nothing's gonna go good, like, at all. Does Bowen not see, like, the crossbows and everything? The music, no! Reigns of Castamere! We need to get the hell out of here, dude. That's one of my favorite songs, though. Soundtracks from the show Reigns of Castamere. What's wrong with him? You! Yeah, you, bro. Okay, my first playthrough, I didn't save Bowen because I thought that he would follow me if I warned Lord Forrester, so I felt really bad when he died, so I'm gonna save him here. Is Bowen blind? Like, did you not see, like, them, like, draw their swords? Or anything? Like, seriously? You gotta get the fuck out of here. Run, you stupid fool. Oh my god, here we go. This is where it all started at the wedding. And Arya was so close, too, to getting back to her family. But at the same time, it's good that she didn't get into the dining hall, because she would have died. It's a good thing that the Hound was there. Oh, whoops. Forgot that this is part of the game.
Garrett, we have to get back.
Fuck off. Like, at least I know Robert Baratheon was a terrible king, but at least he was way better than his not true born son, Joffrey. But I have to say, I do miss Joffrey in the show. Like, even though he was fucking terrible, like, he made the story really interesting. I really miss him. Jack Gleeson's a great guy. I think he's really funny. Bad thing about crossbows, they take too long to reload. He's going down, bro. Still upsets me. Everything could have been avoided if you didn't fucking. No. Button mashing, come on! Oh no, I almost went the wrong way. Shit. You know, one thing about this that bothered me is when Garrett calls out for Roger saying, like, why would you do that? You're completely distracted and they got stabbed and fucking toppled over by a horse. Maybe if he didn't say anything, he'd be fine. Jesus. Oh, look, Bowen got us, alright? What the hell is Garrett doing?
She finds Roderick. Speak up, Garrett. Did you see him or not?
The Freys. They slaughtered him, my lord.
Fucking Freys.
Find a weapon, quickly!
Just take this. Jesus, where did this guy come from? Did he just glitch on my screen? Okay, I don't know.
Lucifer, you fucking traitor! Go, my lord, while there's still time.
No.
Seven hells.
Come on, we have to get out of here.
Keep moving, my lord.
I like Lord Forrester when I first played this game. I really wanted him to make it out, but every single time you like a fucking character in Game of Thrones, they're fucking dead. He's not gonna make it.
Guard this with your life. Return it to Ironrath, where it belongs.
Okay.
There's no time to waste. I'll be damned if I let it fall into the hands of those traitors. You have to go.
You're welcome.
I'll do as you command.
I'll do as you command, my lord.
You have served me well. I know I can count on you. Tell your uncle. Tell him. The North Grove must never be lost. Tell no one but him. Do you understand? You must swear. Tell only your uncle Duncan. The future of the house may depend on it.
I swear that I will, my lord.
Hey, it's those foresters!
Now go. On your honor, you must do this for your house. Go!
Kill those fucking foresters!
Why does... Oh, there's a floating sword. What the fuck? Okay, but I was gonna say, why is Garrett just standing there? Run, bro! Like, they're gonna come after you! And the floating sword, too! Episode 1, Iron from Ice. Garrett should not be walking the King's Road, because, you know, if you learn from the show and the books, King's Road is not exactly safe at this time, especially, who's in power in Westeros is not a good idea. What's this?
Lord. Fresh.
Oh no, that's not a good sign. Pig. Oh. Poor pig. Usually if you see fire or smoke, you'd go the other way. Because, you know, it's not... Especially here in this realm or world. I don't think it's a good idea. Walk faster, Garrett.
That's Father's car.
Shit.
Lord Bolton better give us fucking titles for this.
Oh, fuck. The next friggin'... Oh my goodness. Okay, the family that I hate the most is the Boltons. They freak me out. And they infuriate me at the same time. Like, look at their banner right here. It's a flayed man. Basically, what they do is they take off the skin of their victims and they, because they, you know, I won't go in too much into it, but yeah, that's one of their torture methods is ripping off the skin of people. It's just disgusting. And Roose Bolton is a fucking.
Go along, boy. There's nothing for you here.
Father,
I said move on. Unless you want to get fed to the fucking pigs.
I'm going to kill you.
Is that so?
Garrett was promoted, you know what?
You can try if you like, and then we'll feed you to the pigs.
Right now,
get
that's bullshit.
Off my land!
This is Bolton land now, boy.
Lord Bolton is the new Warden of the North.
Fuck you and your fucking bull haircut.
I reckon he'd like a proper lordly sword like that.
Stupid assholes.
No.
I'll have that sword, boy.
Nah, I'll keep it. I don't think. You know what? Fuck you.
Fuck you.
I find it funny that, okay, he just took the sword, but, Garrett's sword is a much bigger than,
finish this
Bull Cut McGee over here.
Pathetic.
What should I choose? The pitchfork looks nice. Stab it through your chest. Oh! This way? Fuck you. Ooh! I forgot that went through his neck. That's pretty brutal. Not fast enough. Idiot. Yeah. You know, yeah, you shouldn't use that, like, I don't think you can. Oh. Shit! What the fuck? Oh my god, that's the first time that I died in this game, I didn't mean to. Oh, I didn't really click it fast enough. Bala Magules, oh my goodness. Son of a bitch. Alright, let's try that again. Smash, come on. Alright, let's try this again because that was my bad. Oh, I missed it again. Oh my god, I almost did. Oh.
Mercy, please. I beg of you. They'll never survive without me.
I feel like I should kill this asshole.
I was only following orders.
No. God damn it. I'll show you mercy, even though you're a stupid idiot.
Lord Whitehill will see you hang for this. That much I promise.
You should hang you for your haircut. God. I fucking hate the Boltons. But anyway, what I was trying to say was, Ramsay Snow, I think he's much, much, much more worse than Joffrey.
You survived.
Because people forget, Joffrey is only a kid, honestly. He's just a kid. A spoiled kid. And he just commands people to do all his dirty work, and if you look at Ramsay Snow, he doesn't command anybody, he does it himself.
I tried
and,
to stop them.
After what he did to Theon Greyjoy, I mean, it's pretty sick. And then what he did to Sansa, that infuriated me, but what I didn't understand was all the controversy.
I'll
I know, like,
the man who did
if
this.
We can go into, like, rape is not a... not a light subject, but I mean, at the same time, it's happened before in the show. I don't know why there's an outrage for it now. I mean, it shouldn't take, you know what I mean, it shouldn't be taken lightly, but at the same time, like, I don't understand. You're not outraged by the other times it happened, but this time particularly. But yeah, Ramsay, ugh. And then I was upset because Stannis Baratheon was supposed to fucking kill the Boltons. This is what I was hoping for, and then he fucking failed. God damn it.
It's Garrett!
You know, looking at the map, from Iron Wrath, which is House Forrester's home, to the Freys, at the Twins at the Stronghold, Garrett walked pretty far, didn't he?
Garrett!
I was too late. They were already dead.
Bring the maester! Meet us in the Great Hall! Quickly!
Two White Hill soldiers?
And a Bolton.
They came. Alright, people what? Don't know. There's a lot of houses, like household rivalry and
she
stuff
was
like
only
that.
Eight
so,
years old.
Like,
this never
I think the most famous one
it's unimaginable.
Would be
unacceptable.
You have Viracion versus Targaryen, because you know with the Robert's Rebellion and whatever, but for House Forrester, their rivals are actually House Whitehill.
But I should be able to save your leg.
So they
your
both
justice was swift. Some will call it vengeance. No doubt the Whitehills will claim it was murder.
They both harvest ironwood, and obviously House Forrester has done it better
done
than Whitehill. So,
but the Whitehills won't see it that way.
They attacked me. I had no choice but to defend
myself.
Which
is true. I mean, like.
Of course.
And we it's can't not let exactly justice because
all over us.
It doesn't. I don't know. To
these
me, it doesn't bring back his family or doesn't like honor them in any
Hold
way.
The window
I don't know.
For
it,
me, would you?
To me, it's not justice. But yeesh. Oh, that is so disgusting. That's fucking gross. Ugh.
That's
supposed to help him.
To lose the lord of the house and the eldest son through
such
a despicable act
like,
of treachery and
bugs.
Betrayal.
I fucking hate flying insects or bugs. That freaks me out. But I mean,
in times such as this,
maggots.
The late Lord Forrester was a good man, and poor Roderick, a serious man, but he would have made a good lord.
Our house will never fall.
By the gods, let's hope you're right. The future of this house is in Lord Ethan's hands now, although he is young. And altogether unprepared to leave.
Yep. Ethan Forrester is now the lord,
right.
Which is tough. Like, I mean, he's
this
only
might
like
hurt a bit.
I think he's like a 13-year-old kid. I don't remember.
Hold this
but,
down, will you?
He's the third-born son. That's tough. You have to take
I
care of everything.
Understand from your uncle that Lord Forrester saved your
life. A leader
life.
When you're 13.
Rather odd, though, that he chose to save you, his squire, and not his son Roderick.
Well, I mean, why it's odd. If you know House Forrester, he's very,
It's unfortunate the Citadel doesn't train maesters in the after
very, honorable man. How can you doubt him, like that?
With a sword?
Okay, remember when Lord Forrester said, only tell your uncle the Northborn
must never be lost.
Only to Duncan, right? And not telling anyone else. You can have a choice to, like, tell,
blab
your mouth around. I'm not gonna do that.
I'd like you to walk for
because I don't think that's right, but I remember in, my second playthrough that I did, I told the maester here about what Lord Forrester said.
Go on.
He gave
now.
Him this shady
it's
look. Something's wrong with him. I don't trust the maester. He's pretty shady to me. All right. Wicked dialogue.
The Ironwood Grove.
But yeah, the maester, I don't know, he gives up. A lot of maesters are shady, except for Maester Lewin and for House Stark. But yeah, if you think about it, a lot of maesters are pretty shady. Alright, so these are the family members of House Forrester. Let's start with
Lord Forrester.
Forrester.
It was an honor to squire for him. Gregor the Good.
Yes, Gregor, that is his name. I forgot about that.
Roderick.
And this is Roderick, his
he
first son.
He was our
son.
Best warrior by far.
And
Lady Forrester.
Gregor's wife.
She's always been kind to me. Treated me like I was a Forrester myself.
Their firstborn daughter, Mira.
Still in King's Landing, I suppose. Although, I wonder if they'll bring her home.
This is their second son,
Asher. Exiled to Essos, unfortunately.
And they have the twins.
Talia and Ethan. I suppose Lord Ethan now.
Yep, that's right. Ethan is the lord now, and their youngest son, Ryan.
Never easy being the fourth born son.
So those are the members of House Forrester.
Hmm. You seem to be favoring it. Always sad to see a warrior lose a leg.
Okay, I'm gonna take these. Especially in Westeros, you know, it'd be wise to take medical supplies, knowing everything that happens around here.
This might help.
Is this the the maggots. I don't know why, I just fucking touch it.
Cute little creatures, aren't they?
I guess.
Cute? I don't know about that, but, okay. Let's see. Is there anything else I can look at?
Mm-hmm. I may be mistaken. You do seem able to put weight on it.
Did your leg feel weak?
No. I just wanted to ask you. Why do the White Hills hate the Foresters?
I think it's safe to say the feeling is mutual. There's been enmity between the two houses for as long as anyone can remember. I don't doubt someone killed someone, which led to more killings of someones, and then,
which is
well,
always the case, if you think about it, between rival houses. Like, look what started, what happened between Baratheon versus Targaryen. Apparently, Rhaegal kidnapped and raped Lyanna Stark, but it's not... I don't believe that theory. I mean, I believe that they ran away together, because if you think about it, what Peter Baelish said to Sansa in the Crypts of Winterfell, when she mentioned that what happened to Lyanna Stark, and then he said, do you really think that happened? Like, he gives, like, a look. Like, do you really think that happened? Like, there's no way. That's why I don't believe... I believe in L equals J. That theory, if you know what that is.
The White Hills want Forrester Ironwood.
Ah, they'd take it all if we'd let them. Especially now with the Boltons in power. And proceed to clear-cut every last inch of it until there's nothing left. Just as they've done before.
Yeah, so White Hills are not good harvesters like the Foresters. That's why they're called White Hills. So they're a hill with nothing
on
it.
Who's the new lord of House Forrester?
Why, Ethan, of course. At the Citadel, I swore an oath to serve whichever noble house I was assigned. Advising the late Lord Forrester was an honor. Advising Ethan, his third-born son, is challenging. There's still so much he has to learn, yet the very fate and future of this house rests in his hands.
The Maester's still shady to me.
Which is rather frightening when you think about it.
What will happen to me now?
Excellent question. Under normal circumstances, you could join Sir Roiland and his men. Although, given the circumstances of your... circumstances, it becomes a bit tricky, doesn't it? I suppose it will be for Lord Ethan to decide.
Lord Forrester promoted me. At the Twins, I'm no longer a squire, if that matters.
It might, I suppose. But I'll defer to Lord Ethan on this.
Can I see Ethan? Is he here?
He is. But I'm afraid he's indisposed at the moment. He prefers not to be disturbed while practicing his lute.
Really?
Can I go now?
I believe your leg will be fine. Only time will tell, but... Lady Forrester.
Welcome home, Garrett.
Here's the wife and the...
We're all relieved to know you survived.
Oh, that's Ethan's twin.
Thank you, my lady.
Talia asked to see you.
Garrett, I heard what happened. Is it true? Your family... So sorry.
Mato.
God, too many people die.
Off to bed now. Hurry on. Garrett was just telling me how valiantly Lord Forrester fought to the end, even when all was lost. I'm sure Lady Forrester would like to know. Whatever you can recall.
He loved his family, my lady. He was very proud of Roderick.
Yet he was unable to save him.
Ah, shit, maybe I should have.
You were with Roderick, no? I'm sure it was chaos and confusion. But if you can remember anything, I'm sure Lady Forrester would like to know.
He fought valiantly, my lady.
Of course he did. He was House Forrester's best.
This has been so incredibly difficult for us, especially the children. But I was told you were the last to see my husband alive.
Yes, my lady.
I know it may be difficult to remember, but if I may ask, was there anything he said?
Any last words before he passed? If you can remember.
I shouldn't say. I want to say, but saying that I don't think it's a good idea to say.
He asked me to return this to House Forrester.
Or lie about, you know,
with his family.
Making up something that...
Thank you.
Making up something for him that he'll say like that.
He demands a response. It's too dangerous, especially now. Now is the time to prove our strength.
I'll be sure it's given to Ethan.
Duncan, this was our land. They were our people. Your family. I share your outrage, Sir Roiland. I do. But now is not the time to provoke the White Hills. Not with Ramsay Snow coming
Sir
to see
Roland
us bend the knee.
I mean, yeah, Ramsay they Snow, attacked his family, but at the same time you can't
Garrett,
go around like killing everybody.
You killed a Bolton
killed
and Ramsay Snow will want
his
retribution.
It's very dangerous, especially because now Roose Bolton is in power.
We're the ones that should be demanding retribution. This happened on Forrester land.
Ramsay Snow is coming here.
Aye. He'll arrive within the week. Those men will say they were keeping the peace in the name of House Bolton.
You have to
and
be
what
careful
would you
when you...
Nothing.
When you,
I would have us use our heads
like
while they're still attached
the
to our shoulders.
You have to be careful of who...
Garrett has lost as much as anyone else within these
who
walls.
You trust and
maybe
who
you can talk some sense
kill,
into your uncle.
I guess.
Garrett's suffered enough already. You ask too much of the boy. He deserves to be heard. It
we
was his family they killed.
My uncle's right. We need to be smart.
Smart. Eddard Stark was smart. And look where that got him. So,
no, yeah,
what's
he has
to
a point
done?
Too. Ned was very... It's not smart, he was honorable.
Ultimately,
like Robert said, an
Lord
honorable fool,
decide.
Which got him killed.
He's just a boy who can barely hold a sword. He
which
knows
I hope
nothing
I won't
about
be in this game.
He is the lord of this house, and he needs our help. It's bad enough the Boltons would have us bend the knee and swear fealty. But now,
morally good answers, which is not
I'll
a good idea either.
I'll accuse you of murder, and us of protecting you. The boy was just defending himself. I'm not faulting him for what he did. I'd have done the same, as any man would.
I've done nothing wrong.
Not in their eyes. It's just the excuse Ramsay Snow would need to put us to the torch and kill us all. I'd like to see them try. I'm afraid it's a risk we cannot take, which is why you cannot stay. Cannot stay? Duncan, the boy has suffered enough.
But where would I go?
The one place beyond the reach of even House Bolton. You're sending him to the wall. The boy's done nothing wrong.
The
not
nice
in the eyes
now.
Of the Boltons.
Fuck everybody there, by the way.
I'm afraid it's the only solution. Especially now, when the house is so vulnerable.
I'll do what's
so,
best for the house.
The Night's Watch
so
is like a sworn brotherhood
I'm
that you protect the...
I know it
there's a wall
fair,
between...
But it is what's best.
North of the wall and south of the wall, which is all the houses of Westeros. It's been
that
there for
it.
Thousands of years, and the Brothers of the Night's Watch, they guard it.
You can
to make sure no
horse.
White Walkers or no wildlings or any threat comes to
time.
The Seven Kingdoms.
The White
they basically
will
protect
come
the realm.
For you.
But since it is a sworn brotherhood, like you can't, you know, have a family, have a wife, any of that. You swore off everything. Oh, did Duncan just disappear to the okay? But yeah, you swore off everything. So you swore off all your titles, your lands, everything. You just give up every single thing to be there. But at the same time,
word up to me. I gladly drive a sword through Lord Whitehill's heart.
Don't apply to you
chance.
In a sense. So
I would.
That's
and
why
God's willing, someday
Duncan wants
I will.
To send Garrett to
but
the
now,
wall so that nobody
have House
can get him
to
and kill
first.
Him or attack him. You know, sentence
Lord
him to death.
Lord Forrester
basically.
Would be proud that you're putting the interests of the house ahead of your own. Many of Lord Forrester's best men have volunteered for the war. His own great-uncle was a ranger with the Night's Watch.
He promoted me. Met the twins. We were to ride in the van to Casterly Rock and I at Roderick's side, but...
It was well-deserved, Garrett. You worked hard and served your lord with honor.
I've been waiting for the right moment to tell you.
What? What is it?
Lord Forrester's last words were, "The North Grove can never be lost."
Sorry, you caught me by surprise. It's not often discussed.
I feel like I shouldn't ask questions, you know what I mean?
He said, "Tell only you."
I still don't
know
what
reason.
It is.
Most don't even know it exists. They think it's just a myth made up by wildlings and fools, and it's better kept that way. I assume you kept your word. You haven't told anyone else, have you? This is important, Garrett. I need to know the truth.
Of course not. I told no one.
Well done. Lord Forrester was right to put his trust in you. From this day forward, this will be our secret. But soon, I may need your help.
But
I can't say anything more just yet. Just know the North Grove may very well be vital to the future of this house. But don't breathe a word of it to anyone at the Wall. Become a ranger if you can. It will help.
Becoming a ranger is very hard, isn't it? Also, where's Benjen Stark? Everybody, does anybody know where he is? Like, seriously?
Iron from Ice.
Best hide-and-seek player of Westeros.
Remember, you represent House Forrester. Your actions at the Wall will reflect the honor and dignity of the house.
I'll make you proud.
You already have.
Aww.
Garrett, wait!
And Talia is very sweet for giving him the necklace. That defies gravity, apparently.
Be safe. The grove of House Sorcerer where they get their ironwood? I'm just curious. Or is this just like some random place that they
couldn't find him? Could you?
He hides too well, and if he were smart, he would reveal himself.
I don't like this game anymore. Maybe something happened to him.
Ethan's fine. He's just forgotten this is a game.
I won't be
I'm here. It's okay. Don't worry. It's just a game, Ryan.
A stupid game. I don't like it.
He was worried you were gone.
I thought we'd never find you again.
I'm right here. And I promise, I'm not going anywhere.
I wish Mira was here. And Asha. And Roderick.
I do too. But Mira's in King's Landing and—
Can't she come home? I don't want her to die too.
Ryan, she's perfectly safe, I promise you.
I don't want Garrett to die either. Maester Ortengren said he got sent to the Wall.
Okay, that's his name, Ortengren, I forgot.
I'll miss Garrett. He was nice.
I don't know what he did to get sent away like that.
He let me ride one of his pigs once. It was fun.
He'll be fine. Garrett is smart.
No one will tell me what Garrett did, but it must have been serious. I heard Duncan and Sir Roiland talking. They said someone will come here looking for revenge.
Everyone's worried about you, but I'm not. I know you'll protect us.
Who said they're worried about me?
Well, Sir Roiland for one. He says you can't fight very well.
What?
And he calls you a milksop.
What does that mean?
Sir Roiland forgets himself. After all, you are the lord of the house now.
He doesn't know me, or or what I'm capable of.
Exactly.
What does Miltsop mean?
I don't know. But I know it's not good.
Ethan, you should let Sir Roiland teach you how to wield a sword. Like a man. He taught Roderick and Asher, and he even showed me how to fight.
He should be learning how to fight.
A lord should know how to fight.
Do you remember when we were younger? When we all used to play here? You, me, Roderick, Asher. We'd all be out here for hours.
Yeah. Where was I?
You weren't born yet.
We had so much fun. But then, then everything changed. Roderick became so serious.
That's the one thing that sucks about growing up, isn't it?
He never smiled anymore. And Asher just got angry at everything. Promise me you won't be like that. Please, just be you. I like you the way you are.
Aww.
I know a lord has many responsibilities.
But
you don't need to be like them.
I can't promise that, though.
It's for you to decide for yourself.
You may have to change, either way.
I may have to change.
I'd rather have my brother than a lord.
I'll have to have both, I'm afraid.
But since you're the new lord, you can do anything you want.
I suppose.
Everyone will have to do as you say. So I could have all the sweets I want.
If only it were that simple. It would be nice if someone did what I wanted for once.
That's not how it works, though,
Ethan
but
will be
your brain's really cute
a
for saying
lord.
That.
That's not how it works.
Well, that's how it should work. You are the lord.
Lord Ethan, you're needed in the Great Hall at once. Quickly, on your feet.
I feel like that's the last time that we see
What's
Ethan
the matter?
As a...
Lord Whitehill has arrived, unannounced, and certainly unexpected. He's come demanding justice.
Can't he meet with Duncan? He is the Castellan.
Stay with us. Please, Ethan.
He's demanding an audience with the Lord. We really must go.
As much as I
go.
Want him to stay with his siblings,
it's your decision.
Needs to go.
You are the Lord.
If I were Lord, I would command Ethan to stay, with his family. Lord Whitehill is a mean old man anyways.
Fine. If that's what's required of me.
Very well then.
Duty calls now. Wait, why is he going the other way if Ryland's going that way? Okay, well.
They showed up unannounced. Lord Whitehill is in a lather. I assume you explained to Lord Ethan why they're here?
A business with Garrett. I told him.
Lord Whitehill knows Garrett is a squire to this house. Or was, I suppose.
Is, was. It makes no difference. The Whitehills were clearly in the wrong, so don't give him any
satisfaction. There's too much of a power struggle here.
Out there, you were decisive and firm. Now do it again with these bastards.
Let's not do something rash. Things are bad enough as it is.
You know what? Ethan's capable.
I can
believe he is
Lord
capable.
Whitehill.
Well said, my lord.
Now is not the time to anger Lord Whitehill any more
but,
than he already is.
But I will
is.
Take Duncan's
He's got five
advice
times
not to
as many
piss
men
him off royally.
And the backing of House Bolton.
All the more
because
reason
that's not
to
a good
stand
idea.
Up for ourselves.
But
only
Ryland
cowards
has a point.
Dead
you have to be firm to be a lord, so I'm going to make Ethan very confident.
Lord Ethan, is it? My condolences for your father and brother. The late Lord Forrester was no friend to me or my house, but to his family it's still a loss.
I'll just thank him.
Thank you,
Lord. Shake his fucking hand. Fuck you. You don't deserve it.
My only regret is I wasn't there to drive the dagger into his heart myself. I've been waiting for this day all my life. The Foresters finally get their due.
He died a hero, sir.
My father died a hero, fighting for the North against traitors and oathbreakers.
Aye. And look where that got him.
Yeah, but he has a point, too.
And no bread and salt! What kind of fucking house receives a lord with no fucking bread and salt? You bloody amateur.
No courtesies. I should have expected as much. Bloody
I'll just say I'm
foresters.
Sorry, but I'm not getting
my
you anything.
My apologies. Please forgive us.
Forgive you? Not likely. You foresters have shit on us for generations. Well, now the Starks are no longer around to have you back, are they? We're the power in the North now.
Roose
we'll
Bolton
see how long
is
that
the
lasts.
Warden of the North.
Aye. And we've been his bannermen for 5 fucking centuries, you cunt.
Lord Ethan, you're losing control of this.
We all serve House Bolton.
We all serve
now.
Him now.
I'm not finished. Maybe if you hadn't been so fucking greedy with the Ironwood, things would have been different between us.
You squandered your share.
Our share was taken from us. We had no fucking choice but to harvest what was left.
What is it you want, Lord Whitehill?
Oh shit, it's Bolka McGee.
Your man, the Squire. We were minding our own business. Keeping the king's peace, as his lordship here said.
You
when
know,
your
if
man
this guy was a
tunnel, no
I can't... He shouldn't sound so pompous, you know what I mean?
For no reason.
You
no
straight
reason.
Up murdered his family.
You murdered his family.
Then you admit it was your man who killed my men. And a pig farmer at that. How do you answer for your squire, Lord Ethan? He acted in your name. And you are the Lord.
How do you answer for your men?
We lost people too, Lord Whitehill. Your men murdered his entire family.
You lost pig farmers, not soldiers. A soldier's worth 100 of their type.
That's not true.
Where's the fucking coward who killed
you
my men?
You can train anyone to be a soldier.
I know he's here. What have you done with him?
He was sent to the wall.
Who the fuck sent him to the wall? Answer me. Who's the one who did it?
I did.
I did.
What?
Fuck you.
That was my justice to deliver, boy. And you denied me of it.
Damn
right.
I'm
not leaving until I have my justice. Now bring me the coward who did it, or you'll answer to Roose Bolton.
Is this guy not listening?
What kind of fucking house is this?
A house of honorable men.
Lady Forrester.
You bellow like a wounded boar, Lord Whitehill. Have you forgotten your manners?
I mean no disrespect to you, my lady, considering your losses and all.
Uh-huh.
This is not over.
It's over when my son says it is.
Thank you for coming, Lord Whitehill.
Ethan is Lord of Ironwrath now. By rights, his word is law here. If that displeases you, then I trust you can find the door.
That lad may be lord of this house, but Lord Bolton will have the final say. I'll send him a raven letting him know a Forrester man killed one of his own, that the new Lord Forrester lied to my face and denied me my justice. Then we'll see whose word is law.
You know what? Fuck you. Do as you
like.
Do
as you like, Lord Whitehill.
Stupid dick. And you too! Fucking bullhead.
I was wrong about your son, my lady. He stood up to him like a true lord.
You were brave, my son. But you'll need to be braver still when Ramsay Snow arrives to see you
confident.
Bend the knee.
My first Let's Play, I wasn't
prepare
sure what to
raven.
Say, so I was like scrambling
We need to
around.
Send word to Mira in King's Landing
better.
At once.
Alright, so now we're going to King's Landing.
Your sister
very,
can help us.
Very dangerous place.
Although just a handmaiden, she has Marjorie Tyrell's favor. And Lady Marjorie's betrothal to the king may be enough
All
to
right,
keep
so
the Boltons at bay.
Alright, so this is before Marjorie Tyrell
to
gets married to Joffrey
be.
Baratheon. And Mira is the handmaiden for Marjorie. Let's look in her box.
Ethan made this for me.
That's sweet.
Asher sent me this coin. to remember him.
I believe that's what it's
a strange place, Essos.
Essos is across the sea, so it's where Daenerys Targaryen is.
It was very kind
right
of Lady Marjorie to give this to me. It once belonged to Lady Olenna.
And Lady Olenna is Marjorie's grandmother.
Father. Much excitement here in King's Landing for the coming wedding. Lady Marjorie has proven to be quite popular throughout the city. I do wish you and Mother could come, although I know it would be impossible under the circumstances. I miss all of you, and I look forward to the day you can.
That's so sad. Now she can't give it to her father.
Wonders Made by Man by Lomas Longstrider. A gift from Roderick. I hope to see them all someday.
Let's see. Okay, that was nothing. That was pointless. Look out the window.
King's Landing. I wonder if it's sunny at Ironwrath today.
King's Landing is very... like, the castle, I think, is very beautiful, but... the city is, like... it looks like a piece of shit, I can't lie.
It troubles me to even ask this of you, but you must appeal to Lady Marjorie to intervene on our behalf. She is our best hope, and can be a powerful ally. Especially now when your family so desperately needs her help.
I really love the art style of Telltale's games. Like the comic book-ish look. It's nice.
One moment.
Oh, sorry, m'lady. I didn't mean to disturb you. I can come back later if you'd like.
No, that's okay, you can come
No,
in.
It's fine. Come in.
Begging your pardon, m'lady, but you alright?
I want to say something about this too. I know
if
he's trying to help.
Mask, you seem rather upset.
But at the same time, if you think about it, Nier is in a very dangerous
Thank
place,
you.
And it's hard
of course,
to.
M'lady.
To choose who to trust, so
please hurry if you can.
I'm
Lady
going to
Marjorie
try to
be here any minute.
Keep
of course, m'lady.
As much as information as I can, like to Mira
Do
herself
you work
instead
for Lady
of
Marjorie?
Like blabbing it about to like everybody because I don't think it's a good idea. Like if
wrong.
You think about it, it's very dangerous.
But
like
it seems
you don't
like
know
you
who
do.
Will betray you or not. So you have
I'm
to be careful.
Handmaiden.
That's what I thought. I've seen you with her before.
Because if you play
friends.
Like the morally, like 100% the morally right and honorable way, like
outside the royal
like Ned Stark did
Queen
in
Cersei.
Season 1, he
Cersei.
Trusted Peter Baelish, which is like the wrong person to trust, and he got killed. So
they appeared to be
I don't
having
want Mira
some sort
to
of
make
disagreement.
The same mistakes. So
I couldn't
careful.
Hear much, but it was definitely an argument.
What did they say?
I couldn't make out much, but I know they were talking about the Starks and House Forrester.
House Forrester.
I hope you're not in any kind of trouble. But I thought you ought to know. Most people don't tend to notice a call boy. Not in King's Landing, with so many lords and ladies about. You see and hear all sorts of things when people don't even know you're there. Good night, m'lady.
Lady Marjorie, you're early.
I was hoping there would be time for us to talk. Come, there's something we must discuss.
I love Natalie Dormer so much. She's amazing. I think she's a great actress. I know it's hard to depict, like, in Telltale style, like, to make the characters look like from the show. I just think that
From the day you arrived in Highgarden, I've thought of you more as a friend.
Weird. Maybe it's her dress, I don't know.
A dear friend, in fact.
Thank you, my lady.
And you know how I feel about what's happened to your family. I feel your pain as if it were my own. What you've suffered is beyond imagining. And your poor family as well.
You're very kind, my lady.
I know, of course, Marjorie knows how to play the game. She's very good at it, so I have to take advantage of when to let her know.
You must understand there are limits to what I can say, especially here in King's Landing.
Sarah is the other handmaiden behind us who is walking. I don't
have a handmaiden.
I don't know if I can trust her very well.
Rob Stark.
I'll explain later on in the later episodes, but I don't know, I feel like
Cersei
I can't exactly trust her that well.
Cersei cornered me this morning outside the Royal Sept. She mentioned the northern girl in my service, and she painted you a traitor.
Of course she did! Cersei Lannister, or herself. Cersei.
Her face was full of mirth as she said it.
How did you respond?
I told her you are one of my most trusted handmaidens, that you can hardly be blamed for the actions of your father and brother. Nonetheless, she demands an audience. She wants an apology of some sort for what I don't know, but she's waiting for us now, and I've
Cersei
promised
is
I would
very,
bring you to her.
Very,
I wouldn't ask this
wicked?
If it were not important.
I don't know, she's very terrible, too.
I cannot afford any conflict with Cersei with the wedding so near.
I'll do
I
as
think
you
it's
ask,
best to get
lady.
On Marjorie's good side.
I knew
but,
I
could
trust
yeah,
you.
Cersei is very.
Humor her. Tell her what
she's
she
a very
to
terrible
hear.
Woman. But I feel kind of sympathy
See
for her
Queen
for
Regent
everything she's gone
us.
Through. But at the same time, she's deserved everything she's got, especially in the newer season with the Walk of Shame. She deserved it. But you can tell when Robert Strong picked her up and started walking her into
You'll
the castle.
Fine.
Like, you can tell the look
will.
On her face. She's gonna
you
fucking
feel
murder
one
everybody.
Thing, but you must say another.
Especially High Sparrow.
Good luck.
Thanks. I would need it. I would be scared to talk to Cersei, honestly. She's a scary woman. This is the throne room.
You can do this.
Yeah, I hope so. I don't remember exactly what she's gonna ask. But I know, like, there's certain things you have to, well, it makes sense. You have to please her, pretty much, because, serious.
Ah, Lady Marjorie.
I find it kind of random that they're just sitting there. It's kind of weird looking to me.
Your Grace? With your permission, allow me to introduce Lady Mira of House Forrester.
I feel like I should kneel because, you know, Cersei, she's scary.
Well,
Your Grace.
Alright, just please thank God. Okay, I'm scared.
Impressive. You may rise. House Forrester is a northern house loyal to the king.
Are they?
I beg your pardon, Your Grace.
I wasn't talking to you. I want to hear from the girl. Is your family loyal to the king?
Perhaps you should ask the new Lord Forrester.
He's not here, is he? She is.
I feel like
the
I want to see one true king.
For her house.
Joffrey is the one true king, Your Grace.
And yet, for centuries the Forresters have been loyal bannermen to House Stark, a house of traitors.
They were our wardens, sir. We have no choice.
They were the wardens of the North. We all served at the pleasure of the king.
Clever girl.
Yep, you have to answer
Perhaps
smart.
Too clever for her own good.
Like little Tyrion's
The girl did name Joffrey as the one true king.
Is your house
I don't know what
to
else I could
fealty
say.
To your new
Jesus.
Liege lord, Roose Bolton?
He is the Warden of the North, Your Grace.
He is. And I the Queen Regent, and Tyrion the Master of Coin.
The girl has a remarkable talent for answering questions while in fact saying nothing at all.
Alright, good. I want to keep it that way. Because I don't feel like I should give her, like, not easily a promise type of answer. But now that the war is over, we must look to rebuild and forge new alliances.
There are ships and shields to be built, and Joffrey will need a steady supply of ironwood for his armies. I'm told there are others who would happily serve that purpose, but I trust we can rely on House Forrester.
Forrester Ironwood does seem rather unique.
To our mutual benefit, Your Grace.
And at the pleasure of your king.
Yep.
It would be a shame to see it fall into the hands of another house. I imagine you'd do almost anything to prevent that from happening, wouldn't you? Ask any Lannister, and they'd do whatever was necessary to save Casterly Rock. It would be unfortunate to see another house lay claim to what's yours.
Yes, Your Grace. I would do anything.
I see.
Maybe I shouldn't say that. Ooh, no.
What would you have the girl do, Cersei? It's not as if she fought beside the Starks, wielding a battle axe for the Northern Army.
It raises an interesting question, I suppose. Can we truly blame those who end up on the wrong side of the war? Our dear Marjorie here was betrothed to Renly Baratheon on the false assumption that he would one day rule the Seven Kingdoms. Can we fault her for her mistake? Should she be held accountable?
No. No. I'm sure she regrets it, you know.
I'm sure she regrets it.
Let's be honest here. Marjorie perhaps didn't really love Renly. She just wants to be queen.
If there's a point to this, I hope you find it quickly.
Loyalty can be such a hard thing to define. This city alone is filled with all sorts of ambitious opportunists looking to reinvent themselves, pretending to be something they're not. Who knows what lurks within their hearts? You are a girl from the north, here in service to Lady Marjorie. One can only assume her interests are yours. Yet loyalty to a king, that must be absolute, beyond question. And if your loyalties were to become conflicted between your king and the very person whom you serve, what would you do then?
I'm sure she
would...
Let
the girl answer the question.
For me, I'll pick the...
Go on.
I would be true
to the king.
I
have to please Cersei. There's no doubt. I'm sorry, Marjorie.
I was beginning to worry you didn't have your priorities straight.
She is...
But I would pick Marjorie over Joffrey,
isn't she? The most dangerous handmaiden in all of King's Landing.
My sense is this girl will say almost anything to get what she wants. Which is not very encouraging.
Really?
I'd like a word with you, if I may.
Of course, Your Grace.
I hope she was fine with that. That look Marjorie gave was not very, pleasing.
I'll walk you out.
I really like Tyrion. Tyrion is one of my favorite
characters. But I met your father once. At the tourney at
Lannisport. And he played with Peter Dinklage. Peter Dinklage is a good actor.
Even then he didn't dress Roose Bolton. We only spoke briefly, but your father struck me as an honorable man. You have my condolences for his loss. These would be trying times for your family, even under the best
thanks.
Of circumstances.
I don't want to burst
thank
out
you,
and say,
Lord
please
Tyrion.
Help me.
That's very kind of you to say.
In the middle of, the throne room. I don't
that's
think that's a good idea.
That certainly took courage. To so publicly declare your loyalty to Joffrey for all to hear. Poor Lady Marjorie was humiliated, although Cersei seemed quite pleased. It was quite the first impression. I, of course, found it all highly entertaining.
I was trying to appease her.
I think that was clear to everyone. My sister and I have our differences. She takes great pleasure in her little charades. I take mine in thwarting them. We must find our amusements where we can. She threatened to give your ironwood to another house. It is the master of coin who decides such matters. The crown needs boats. Boats need wood, and I speak for the crown in this regard.
I'll just ask what he
not
means.
Her.
What are you suggesting?
I suppose
it looks like
the
those people in the background are like black and white. Did you notice that?
House Forrester? Lady Marjorie might not look favorably on such an alliance, and it would infuriate Cersei. Although what would be amusing for me might prove rather dangerous for you and your house. Are you willing to risk that? It may be far too dangerous.
No,
in fact, forget I even suggested such a thing.
It's a risk I'm willing to take, Lord Tyrion. Please.
I mean, you'll do anything to protect your own, right? But
I'll consider it.
It's very dangerous.
Now, if you'll excuse me, I promised Sansa I would join her.
Tyrion is much more trustworthy.
Three beautiful bottles of Dornish wine await my arrival. The mere thought of them makes me thirsty already.
Good night, Lord Tyrion.
Just be careful. This is not the North. King's Landing can be a nest of vipers to the uninitiated.
Mira, I was worried. How was it? Cersei has a way of looking at you as though you're nothing. It's more than a little intimidating.
It didn't go very well.
I'm sorry. Cersei is known for being rather difficult. But at least it's over now. Lady Marjorie has spent the entire day working on seating arrangements for the wedding. Of course, you and I are seated way at the back. Here with the fourth cousins and the ninth.
You know, if Joffrey didn't die during the wedding, I really think that Marjorie could have had like a positive effect on Joffrey because she knows how to manipulate him, I guess.
And Oberyn Martell.
Oh, and Oberyn Martell. I love Oberyn so much. Fuck, but he died too.
I'm told he has a paramour, which I doubt is Dornish for wife.
He is pretty handsome.
I'm not gonna lie. Quite passionate, from what I've heard. Perhaps Lady Marjorie can make the right introductions. Who knows? We might meet our future husbands. Although, marrying a king, I can only imagine what that would be like. Would you marry Joffrey if it meant you'd become queen?
No, hell no.
He does have a certain look about him. And he's always treated Lady Marjorie well. Which is more than you can say for his mother.
I'd rather not
be queen, no matter who I'd have to marry.
Don't want to be queen? You northerners.
Too much responsibility.
You'd make a perfect scepter. Well, I would marry him. Imagine the power you would have as queen of the Seven Kingdoms. I might even allow you to be my handmaiden.
I feel I feel like being queen right now, like, as Lannisters in power, she doesn't, Queen Cersei doesn't have that much power, she just orders people around.
What a perfect match! Sir Bronn and...
What are you doing? Well?
I'm sorry.
Sarah?
I'm sorry, my lady. As am I. We shouldn't have been messing about.
This is not a game. It's a battle plan. Allies and enemies can be made with every move. Yet they say it is men who are powerful.
Damn right.
The Queen was pleased by your display, Mira.
Okay, good.
I'm just glad it's over.
I'm sorry for Marjorie, though, but I had to humiliate her like
that. King's Landing
can
be exhausting sometimes. There's always someone to please or some perceived slight to smooth over. I fear it will only get worse when I am queen.
Once they know your true heart, the lords and ladies will have no choice but to love you.
Do you agree?
I think it matters what you say, doesn't it?
It doesn't matter what you feel. It only matters what you say.
You learn very quickly.
All right, good. But it's true, though.
Your words to Cersei were brave.
The right words go a long way.
You must fear
like, look at
what
how Cersei has survived this long.
Family.
Even Marjorie.
I do appreciate your willingness to appease her.
If you say how you feel, like, I'll give an example, Sansa.
Thank you, my lady.
There's
been something.
But I can't blame Sansa either, because she was just a child, and, you know, she brought up with all these stories and stuff. So, I'll ask Marjorie for help. I feel like she could do something.
I did have a favor to ask of you in return.
Whatever you wish to say, you can say it in front of Sarah.
I can't say it in front of Sarah. I feel like I just can't trust her. I don't know. Like,
it's
let me know in the comments if you guys let Sarah stay in the room if you played this game. I feel like I can't I can't have her there. Like, I need to keep it away from her, so... Sorry, Sarah.
I prefer to speak with you alone.
I don't know, I just feel like she could betray us at any time and then she would, like, use it against us or something like that. You know what I mean?
Go on. Ask.
Please, Ramsay Snow is on his way to Ironwrath to see my brother bend the knee.
Ramsay? Roose Bolton's bastard.
I fear my family will suffer.
I feel like
if
I said my mother
Ramsay's
needed help, like,
likes.
It's not proper.
But if a raven could,
like,
be sent to the Boltons
Mira should
to let
the
them know
responsibility
how Forrester
she
has
is acting.
The protection of the crown.
Margaery herself.
That is no small request, especially now. Joffrey knows only too well your family fought for the Starks, and now you would have me ask him to intervene. Is the situation that dire? Joffrey will not look favorably on such a request.
Please.
Please, Lady Margaery, I beg of you. I fear for my family's safety.
I don't know, Mira. If Cersei were to find out...
Joffrey likes Margaery.
Don't let the Queen bully you. You have power over him, Lady Margaery, as no one else does. Not even his mother.
That is true.
Ramsay Snow will arrive at Ironwrath within a week.
Joffrey likes Margaery compared to, like, Sansa, because Margaery
if it weren't so
lets
urgent.
Him be his self, I guess you could say that. And she takes interest in what he likes.
Very
so
well.
She's a smart
I'll
woman.
Make your request, but I cannot promise anything.
Thank you, my lady. I will send a raven to my family at once.
This sucks. I do feel bad for asking too, because you could see it on Marjorie's face. She's worried. Anything could go wrong. Alright. This is the Wolf's Wood, so, yeah, we're still in our, Ironwrath.
Seven elves.
Uh-oh.
I am loyal to your father. I am loyal to have both, please. No.
Has it been a week? Because, Duncan said that.
Shall we?
Ugh, God, Ramsay Snow. Fuck, I hate
it. Their enemies as a coat.
So disgusting what they do to the people that they torture. It's so gross. Like, you see firsthand with Theon, and then later on in season 5 with that lady that tries to help Sansa.
Not my best work, unfortunately. I suppose I have fallen out of practice.
That's so...
But he didn't make it easy. What with all that bloody noise?
Like a drowning cat. I thought he'd never stop.
As my father likes to say, a naked man holds few secrets, but the flayed man holds none.
Pity he didn't know your father was the Warden of the North.
That's terrible torture.
He does now. How much further is it to these Forresters?
But yeah, like I was saying, didn't Duncan say it was like a week
what was that?
Before Ramsay gets there? So how long was fucking Garrett traveling? Was he really traveling that long? Jeez.
There. Hear that?
I feel like, no, stay. Because usually if you run, that would make a lot more noise. I don't think that's a good idea.
Never mind. We've wasted enough time already.
God, Ramsay Snow, why? All right.
no. I feel bad for this guy. I still don't understand why the Boltons do this. Like, why they, like... why they skin their enemies and stuff like that. It's so disgusting. I don't know much about this theory, but people saying that Roose Bolton is like a skin changer or whatever the fuck that means. He wears the skin of their enemies and then he lives long. I don't know. I don't know too much about that theory, but still, it's just, ugh. Something I hate about Boltons.
Lord Ethan, as I was saying, you are young, and there are those within these walls who are uncertain of your leadership. But 300 generations of Forrester lords stand behind you.
I have a question for you guys too. I forgot to ask this in the beginning. Do you guys trust the Maester?
Our house, and your grandfather.
Without spoiling like episode 5 for me, because I haven't seen it, but I mean,
White Hills.
From episode 1 to 4, do you guys trust the Maester at all?
Lord Gregor the
Good.
Because,
I don't know, I just think he's very shady.
He was fair and wise and courageous in battle.
I want to be like his father. I want Ethan to be like his father, sorry.
Your father was well regarded by nearly everyone. That took years, if not decades, to earn.
That's true. It will take time for Ethan.
These were your father's people to lead and protect,
secret.
And now they're yours. But your father did not bear this responsibility alone. He and every Forrester lord before him chose one man whom they trusted above all others, the Lord Sentinel. Forrester traditions demand that a new Lord Sentinel must be chosen.
Keep walking, you craven son of a whore. Move!
Uh-oh.
Summon the Lord! We need his...
He doesn't need to be kicking him, let's be honest here.
I've done nothing wrong! I was only trying to survive!
Lord Ethan! Miss.
Yeah, let me ask, why did you kick him?
Why did you kick this man?
This craven is a deserter and a thief.
This house is doomed! We all fucking know it!
Quiet, thief. Eric was supposed to be guarding our weapons, but instead we caught him stealing them.
Two shields and three spears.
Why'd you do it?
Why did you do it?
Because I've no wish to die!
So what, if you think you steal the swords and whatever, and you fled, you'll get far? Like,
it's
seriously, the North is huge.
It's not stealing if you're taking what's yours by right!
I don't think that's gonna work that way, and especially now Bolton's in power, like,
they're not two coins to rub together since Lord Gregor left us to rot here. Where's our pay? Our share of bread and wine grows smaller every day!
Leave the poor man alone!
Mercy! Go. Lord Ethan, I know these words are hard, but they're honest. This house is falling. We'll never survive the coming winter. Most of us won't even live to see it.
Alright, first of all, calm down.
Calm yourself.
The time for calm passed with the late Lord Forrester. Now there's only chaos.
You'll address him as Lord.
Rylan's very tough.
Lord Ethan, you must decide the punishment. Lord Gregor always took a thief's fingers. Three of them.
Now may not be the time for harsh punishment. The men are on edge as it is.
Men need to know they cannot do whatever the fuck they please. Their lord will not permit it.
He can send him to the war.
I feel like... Because I know I have a choice there. I can send him to the wall. What else can I do?
I will decide.
Send him to the wall.
Take his fingers.
Let me see. I forget.
If you punish me, you'll be punishing an innocent man.
But you need to be punished. This does not matter. You did a crime, you still have to pay for it.
Please,
that's how it works. Alright, so I can take three fingers, show mercy, or send him to the wall. I don't think I should send him to the wall because I think that's too drastic. If I show him mercy, it's not gonna show that, you know, Ethan has authority over his people. So I believe that he should take three fingers because he did steal from the Forrester, so I think it's right that
he takes three fingers.
I, Ethan of House Forrester, Lord of Ironwrath, name you a thief.
A thief! Kill him!
The price for your crime is three of your fingers.
No! Please, my lord!
I'm sorry.
My lord, please!
But it's the right thing to do.
Please, no!
My lord, normally it is the lord's duty to carry out the sentence. But I am willing to carry it.
No, I think Ethan should do it. He sentenced him, so he should carry it out.
I will carry out the sentence.
It makes sense for him to do that, and it makes him take responsibility as the lord, so yeah.
This is injustice, my lord!
It's not injustice, okay? I don't believe it is. I'm sorry about your fingers. And I know Talia's like, my brother is not being my brother anymore, but she has to understand, like, this is what it meant to be a lord, like, I'm sorry.
That was certainly unpleasant, but a lord must mete out punishment when it's due.
Exactly.
Not just yourself, of course.
You have to carry out your duty, that's the thing.
It's a lord's duty, so I did it.
You heard what the thief said. I expect this sort of thing will happen again. But a sentinel can help you in the face of disloyalty. You need someone you can trust by your side.
I'd be freaked out as well. Like, Boltons are coming this way and they'll kill us all, basically. Or take
no matter
all
the circumstance.
Stuff, so.
Possessing wisdom and experience.
And I'm sure you think you'd be the perfect choice.
Me? Oh, gods, no. I can't get involved. I am a maester. At the Citadel, I swore an oath to serve as such. There are two capable men for the role.
All right, I thought he was gonna say like,
they both want the job.
No, not me or something like that.
Neither thinks very
highly
of the other.
All right.
How do I decide between them?
Talk to them. Solicit the opinion of people close to you. Here, the bracer of the Sentinel.
Okay. My first playthrough, I picked Sir Roiland to be my castellan.
It would be wise to bestow this bracer upon the Sentinel then, to show that you are decisive.
I don't know if that was the right thing to do or not, because I mean,
your Sentinel will wear this for all to see.
Because I know Roiland has like the good art, like, you know, general.
Come speak with me when you're ready
him,
to convene a small council.
Duncan, at the same time, is very smart. He knows how to play the game in a sense. So, but I picked Roiland because I thought it would be a good thing to do because of, you know, the Boltons. So right now, we need like a strategic plan against them. It's hard, but I don't know if I made the right choice or not. So I'm going to try to make Duncan the castellan this time. Or Sentinel, I keep calling it Castellan, but I just want to see if that was the right choice or not. I might regret it, I might not, I don't know. What did you guys pick for your Sentinel? Let me know. Alright, let's talk to Ryan.
Careful. Keep at it and you won't have much left. Something to pick your teeth with.
No, Ethan. Look at this. All good swords have a name. I call mine Two Brothers. I carved this to give me strength. And this, so I remember.
That's sweet.
I mean,
what about
I can
Asher?
Never forget. But, you know, don't you?
I'm honored.
I think it's best to make Ryan happy right now because the situation is pretty shitty.
Someday, I'll have a real one, but not like that one. Only a lord could have that sword.
You'll have a good sword. I'm sure of it.
I watched you today. I saw what you did to that man. Was he our enemy?
No.
A bad man. Everyone keeps talking about them. Enemies.
He's not.
No, he's not our enemy. But he did a bad thing.
People who do bad things need to be punished. Someone did something bad to Father and Roderick. Someone should hurt them even worse.
Yeah.
I want a real sword.
I hope Walter
no one's
gets
afraid of
coming.
Wood. I'll find the men who took Roderick someday, and I'll make sure I have
a real
sword.
I have a question. Does anybody know what happened to Edmure Tully after the wedding? Is he still, like, alive? Because after they killed the Starks and, during the wedding, is when they just carried up Edmure and, Walda, I guess is her name, away. So I'm just
I'm just wondering if anybody knows what happened to them.
You can lift
Let's yeah. talk to Malcolm.
Ethan. Or should I say Lord Ethan?
Hello, Uncle Malcolm.
So, Malcolm is the brother of Lady Forrester.
It's not an easy thing to do, dealing out a harsh punishment, no matter how warranted. But if you'll excuse me, my lord, I should finish packing before nightfall. I hope to be off tomorrow. At first light.
Where are you going?
Where are you going?
Your mother asked me to cross the narrow sea to find your brother, Asher.
Asher?
She has asked me to return with him, to help the house.
She said nothing of this to me.
Because she fears you will not agree. I told her my place is here, that I'll be of no help to you in Essos. But she insisted. I will hold, of course.
I know Asher is exiled,
just try to be kind to her.
In their dire situation, I think Ethan's mother is right, that he should come home.
She's my mother. I know how to speak to her.
I'm sure you do.
But my mother's fears are not the only ones I face. My people are scared as well. I'm told I must choose a sentinel.
If I may be so bold, Sir Roiland is the man for the job.
I don't know, this is so tough to...
It'd be a fine choice.
Right.
And I'd trust him.
Let me see, why are you so...
Sir Roiland is the man you want.
Why Sir Roiland?
We are at war. You need a warrior by your side. Roiland has the respect of his men and will bring strength and discipline to this house. Duncan would offer sage advice, but now is not the time to negotiate. Not with the likes of Ramsay Snow.
Thank you, Uncle.
Ethan, I need to talk to you.
Uh-oh.
Mother told me Mira has asked for Lady Marjorie's help.
Did she?
I knew we could rely on Mira. She always thinks of family above all else. Hopefully Lady Marjorie's influence will be enough. But right now I'm more concerned about you. I saw what you did to that man.
Talia, you don't know.
The way you punished him? How could you be so cruel?
She's still too innocent.
I'm worried about you. What am I supposed to think?
I did what I had to, and I stand by it.
You talk like it was the only thing to be done. I know you told me you'd have to change, but I suppose I hadn't believed you would.
Talia, come on.
I can't afford any more mistakes. Everyone knows what happened with Lord Whitehill. Garrod being sent to the war without my knowledge.
I know, and that wasn't your fault.
But I'm the Lord. It's my responsibility. The people want me to lead. They need me to, but...
What?
Not easy.
Ethan, please. Tell me.
I wish Father were here.
We all do, but Father's gone. You are the lord of this house, which is why you must be strong. You're just as capable as Asher or
Lord. If you understand that, Talia, then you're contradicting yourself by saying, why is Ethan doing all these, like...
I only wish you did
quote,
too.
Quote-unquote, cruel things.
You've always given me good advice. Thank you.
But she is a sweet sister, I will say. Okay. You know, let's just... look at the food. Looks like we're running low.
Our provisions are rather low, my lord. I made the count again, just to be sure.
See, how long could we last?
But it doesn't look good.
How bad is it? How long could we hold the house?
We couldn't withstand a siege, my lord. If the Boltons or the White Hills cut us off and wait us out, we'd only last a fortnight. But there are steps we can take. In the past, we've demanded food from the small folk to replenish our stores. We can do it again, if you'd like. We've done it before in desperate times. The last long winter, my
only
family had to give all our
pigs. I feel like we shouldn't demand people for
That's
food
what's
if
necessary
we don't
to keep the house safe. Then we must.
Because that's not fair to them as well.
But it's what has to be done. I'll see to the arrangements, my lord.
Alright, now I'm gonna decide.
Duncan.
Yes, my lord.
I have much to consider and face a difficult decision.
Perhaps I can help. Your father often sought my counsel.
as Lord, I must name a sentinel.
Of course. And if I may ask, who do you favor for the role? Perhaps I can share my insight. And talking can sometimes help you make a decision.
Actually, I wanted to ask, why did you send Garrett away?
I did it for your own protection, my lord. Garrett had to go. By sending him away myself, I thought it would keep you blameless in the eyes of the White Hills. I only hope to give you an advantage.
I understand that he's trying to look at Ethan, but at the same time...
I understand.
He should have told Ethan what was going on, because he is in charge,
you
know?
Thank you, Duncan. I appreciate your advice.
Because in case something goes wrong or whatever,
at your service, my lord.
Ethan knows. Okay. I guess I'm not going to talk much about... Alright, let's talk to Sir Riley.
Oops. Sword up! Swing left! Sorry! Wrong! I didn't know
Sir
dogs could hold swords.
A word?
Of course, my lord.
I have many decisions to make, and I wanted your advice.
Let's just ask about the sentinel first.
I need to name a sentinel.
Ah, you do. And it's good you came to me.
I know this house, and everyone here knows me. They know I can hold the reins, or wield the sword in equal measure. I'm the man you need.
And might I remind you, it was Duncan Tuttle who sent Garrett to the wall.
I know.
He undermined your authority, and made you look weak to the White Hills.
I would never do that to you.
What have you done?
And
we
if
just
you pardon
said,
me
oh,
saying so,
you can bloody
your
have
father
me or whatever.
Would be seeing you make good choices as a young lord.
I haven't made my decision yet. But I appreciate your opinion.
Like we shut them down.
So, when will you declare your decision, my lord?
Tonight, at the small council meeting.
Very good. I trust your judgment, my lord.
All right. Can I still talk to him about the defenses, though?
Yes, my lord.
All right.
What's the state of our defenses? Are these men ready for what's coming?
This lot, ready? No, but they will be. We post anyone who can hold a spear along the parapet, up where they won't get much scrutiny,
yeah,
and put our meanest, nastiest looking brutes front and center.
That'll
show Ramsay we're a force in our own.
Who's capable of doing it?
You've got to project
point,
power,
desperate.
Especially when you're weakened.
Thank you, Sir Roiland. I'll let you get back to training these men.
Thank you, my lord. And, you should know that swinging that blade yourself took stones. It was a man's way of justice.
Okay.
You're all worthless and...
I don't know, I think I'm just gonna make Duncan, sentinel. Can I not get by here? Oh, okay. Let's talk to the mason. There's the... alright.
Maester?
Yes, Lord Ethan. I see you've spoken to a number of people. Are you prepared to name your sentinel?
What about you?
What is it you're doing over here?
Admiring the ironwood, my lord. I studied it at the Citadel. The wood may be black, but I see gold. An entire forest of gold.
What do you mean?
It is our greatest asset, my lord. Why not give some of our ironwood to House Bolton? And have
that
them leave
won't
us
work,
be.
Because I feel
we
like if you give
ourselves.
Them, like, whatever amount of...
You can
of,
hardly put a price on your own life, or the lives
Iron
of those you love.
Them, they would
ransom
still be asking
or a
for
robbery.
More, because...
You may pay him now, but what's
because
to stop him
Boltons,
from coming back again?
Because
of
the Boltons, they have power, their wardens,
Ethan,
and so basically they'll
the
use it against us.
The dangers of today outweigh the fears of tomorrow.
Okay,
my lord,
I think I'm done.
Are you now ready to name your sentinel?
Yeah. Yes, I am. Let's get out of here.
Yes, maester. I'm ready.
I hope
Very
I
well.
Make the right decision.
I will convene the small council at once.
For a sentinel. I hate this. I'm so indecisive. This is one of the disadvantages of me playing a Telltale game, because I can't make decisions. I'm very terrible. Especially the first time I play an episode or a game like this, I will pause the game and sit there for like 10 minutes thinking like what's the right decision. But I won't do this here, so.
You may sit.
All right. I have to make Ethan act like
a lord. I believe
Lord
Ethan has reached his decision.
Before I name my sentinel, I must tell you.
I believe you're both worthy.
Duncan,
no doubt.
Roiland, this house needs you both.
But you can only choose
Shut
one,
up, Meester, I'm trying to give a
speech. Let him be on with it.
Many thought either of you would make a fine sentinel, but I have made my decision.
Oh, I hate making decisions. I'll just give it to Duncan. I hope this is right.
Duncan Tuttle, you will be my sentinel.
Tuttle? This is reckless.
Lord Ethan has made his choice.
I know you're mad, but I was saying that you can't really disrespect
I will not disappoint
Ethan's
you, my lord.
Choice, you know what I mean? I hope you won't disappoint
now,
him.
Sentinel. What do you have to report of Ramsay Snow?
Our scouts say he's only a day's ride from here, with no time to waste.
Who knows what he's capable of? We need to prepare for the worst.
We will deal with him.
We can devise a plan to deal with him.
The Boltons need our people to harvest the ironwood. Even the bastard Ramsay must understand that.
He's not coming here to negotiate. We must answer with the sword. That's bloody suicide. You
no,
gamble with the lives
idea.
Of everyone within
with
these walls.
You shouldn't
Ignore Sir Roiland.
Ramsay like that.
You named me Sentinel. I knew this would happen. He cannot be trusted.
It is the bloody small council. Lord Ethan deserves to hear from all of us.
Enough! Would my father have stood for this kind of bickering? Neither will I.
Sir Roiland is clearly able and ready to take up arms, but the rest of our soldiers are
not.
That's
not a good idea, because Ramsay is a very violent man,
diplomacy
so if you attack him with violence,
a
I believe he'll...
A sword. The Bolton sigil is a flayed man. Force
well,
is the
so.
Only thing they understand.
Gentlemen, please. Thank the gods Mira has asked Lady Marjorie for her help. It's not too late for the Crown to intervene on our behalf. But we must have a plan if Mira's efforts are not successful. I trust Mira's judgment. I don't doubt she did everything within her power to help us.
Mother, what do you recommend we do?
We must give him whatever he wants and be done with it. It's too dangerous to do
otherwise. But that's not a good idea either, to give him everything, because...
Why not make an offering for peace, my lord?
Yeah, the wisdom of the Citadel.
We can give the Boltons ironwood in exchange for their protection.
You must be mad. It's pure folly to just give away the only currency we have to bargain with.
Enough!
No, we have to use If we fight, it's just gonna end in a battle because they have too many men. If we bargain, they'll just take all of our shit. Diplomacy seems like the smartest way, but at the same time, it's not a good idea either. Because like I said in the beginning, honor gets you killed. You can be an honorable fool, but... I guess I'll pick diplomacy.
My new sentinel favors a certain approach, and I agree. I shall use diplomacy with Lord Snow.
It goes a long way.
I would be foolish to pick a fight without negotiating first. I'll offer our allegiance and try to reach a reasonable agreement.
If you aren't ready for a fight, you're bound to lose when one breaks out.
Ethan has made his opinion known, and you will respect his decision.
Forgive us, my lord. We are, of course, here to serve you, as we served your father.
Aye.
Well then, okay. Let's decide how we shall set the stage for Ramsay's arrival. Invite him into this hall, and meet him face to face, lord to lord.
Ramsay Snow is no lord. That's absurd.
I agree with Roiland. He is no lord.
Meet him at the gate with as much force as we can muster. Make him wait. Let him gaze upon Ironwrath.
But I don't think we should anger him
either. He'll know it's only
because
you
allowed it. Wait outside. He's just gonna get even more pissed off. Because that's what I did in my first Let's Play. My first playthrough of this episode. I made him wait outside, and that wasn't a good idea because he just got even more angry. So I'm gonna invite him into the Great Hall because. At least that way, you have the
courage
to face him, I guess.
A wise move, my lord.
It's careless.
Can't you see Tuttle is steering you wrong?
Hey, that's don't question Roiland. Ethan's judgment.
Lord Ethan has given his command.
How many years have I served this house? I cannot listen to that bloody idiot anymore. Forgive me, my lord, but you are not ready to be lord of this house.
Really?
You're likely to get us all killed.
You know what? Sit down, bro.
Sit down at once.
That's right. Know your place.
Apologies, my son. But now that it is settled,
I don't know that he doesn't even apologize on his behalf.
You will meet Ramsay Snow in the Great Hall. And we will not offer our ironwood.
Damn right we won't.
And don't worry, Lord Ethan. I will stand beside you, where your sentinel belongs.
Then perhaps we should adjourn. We have to prepare the house.
Too many tough decisions.
My lord, I have fought for this family for many years.
I would never forget that, Roiland. Just upsets me that he questions him too much.
There will always
be those
who question
your leadership.
I mean, Duncan
does that too if you choose
Roiland
as sentinel,
which is why you need allies you can rely on.
Roiland's a much more
family.
Aggressive.
Mira has done everything she can in King's Landing, but there are others who can help us. What about your brother, Asher?
Malcolm told me. You want to bring him back.
He's a skilled fighter. But what's more, he has the will to fight. A hunger for it. He always protected you and your sister. And we need all the help we can get.
She has a point.
Yes, I hear what you're saying.
Asher is more, responsive,
I guess. Do you remember the
Miller's
boy? How
he
tormented
wait.
You.
Like, because I'm playing
as,
like,
intervene,
you know, smart way. He's more of, like,
said,
aggressive. He'll
Ethan
jump into
fight
him
his own
and
battles.
Do what needs to be done.
But when Asher saw it,
so I believe Asher is a, good person
he
to have
the Miller's boy by the neck.
In the
that
army,
was his
but to
first
run
instinct.
The house? Nah.
Asher knocked out half the poor boy's teeth. Of course, your father was furious, but you were in danger and there was nothing else Asher needed to know. Asher does not hesitate. He acts, and we need that. You have many fine qualities, but you do not have that anger inside you.
I'm not like that,
yeah.
But I don't need to be, do I?
No, but you need someone who is standing beside you.
His mother has a point, though.
I'm trying to do what's best for this family. What this family needs. Ethan, let me send Malcolm to Essos.
I've done the other side of it, keeping Malcolm here. He still goes in the end, but no, I think it's best that I send Malcolm to Essos.
Fine. Malcolm will go to Essos and bring Asher back.
Because the faster he leaves, I guess, the faster
Thank
Asher
you,
will
Ethan.
Come.
Thank you, I'm glad you will let me do this. Know that you never stand alone. You are a Forrester. Mira stands with us, and she may be able to help us yet.
Gee, I hope so. Okay. There's a key. I don't know if I should take it, especially, this is the Tyrell family seal, which they used to, like, seal letters and stuff with wax. I don't know if I should take the- Okay, let me know in the comments, did you guys take, these two items, the seal and, the key? Because I feel like it's not a good idea to have either of these, you know what I mean? So I'm just not going to take it. I want to see what happens. I'm not going to take either of them.
Marjorie? Oh. Lady Marjorie is still with the king. I thought you might want to know.
Sarah's upset with me.
Thank you. I thought we were friends, Mira. When you dismissed me the other day, I won't say it didn't hurt my feelings. We've known each other for years.
All I can say is
and
I'm sorry.
To be treated like that.
I just don't trust her
sorry,
enough
Sarah.
To...
You
with the information, you know what I mean?
Well, I did. I thought there was trust between us. Friends don't hold secrets from one another. Now Lady Marjorie
like
thinks you don't trust me. And she values your opinion very much. Sarah, I... My lady, I'll leave you to talk. Are you all right, my lady?
Of course not.
The king was not inclined to offer help for your family.
I can see the terror on her
I'll need
dress.
This mended.
Oh, like Joker, abuser. Or not abuser, but...
He said I was too easily swayed. And he reminded me that I am not yet his wife. I allayed his fear. For now. But it will be a long time before I can ask him for anything again. Nothing I said could cheer him. He wouldn't even speak to me when
I
left him.
What can I do to make this better, my lady?
But at the same time, I don't think...
There's
I don't know, this dialogue is kind of weird that they're saying that...
Please don't hold it against
me. Got angry with her because I don't really see him doing that. At least to this
Ramsay
extent.
Ramsay Snow is on his way to Ironwrath.
This is simply not how things are done, Mira. Not in King's Landing.
I'm sorry, my lady.
Soon I will be queen. And maybe then I'll be in a better
yeah,
position
to help
you. Yeah,
if this happened when
you.
Marjorie's already
but
queen,
now,
then yeah, they'd definitely have
now,
an advantage, but...
we must both be cautious.
It's
I
not
must
gonna
send
work
a raven.
Out that way.
I have to warn my family. If you'll excuse me, my lady.
Eesh.
My lady.
It's, the coal boy.
Begging your pardon, my lady. I hope I didn't
Let's
frighten.
Just ask how long he's been standing there.
How long have you been waiting there?
Not long. I was just passing by when I saw you emerge from Lady Marjorie's room. I hope you saw. I was right before. About Lady Marjorie and Queen Cersei. I just want you to know. I can help you if you'd like. And your family, if you're willing to trust me.
Do you guys...
I hear all sorts of things. Things that could be useful for you.
Let's ask how we can help.
How can you?
Do you guys trust
my problems can't be solved by what you might overhear.
This
Which
this
is why you must trust me, m'lady. You need allies.
I feel like I can put trust in
Hopefully
him, but at the same time, I have
to be
careful.
To
it is King's Landing, so...
I'm sorry. I really must go.
Please don't despair. I know people who...
But I'm wondering who he's talking about. He knows people.
People who'd be willing to help you.
Like, other people who work in the castle, or just, like, other people outside? What is he looking at?
Where's Sir Roiland? He should be here.
So, if you pick, Roiland to be your,
more than honor.
We'll Sentinel, do without him. Duncan doesn't show up.
And without King's Landing. I know you'd hoped Mira could help us, but I'm confident we've enough strength
know.
Of our own.
It seems out of character
Your men
if he
stand
leaves
ready
too. That's
to
weird.
Act if needed.
We'll be fine.
Our plan is a good one. It will work so long as everyone does their part.
You have to be confident if you're facing Ramsay Snow.
Isn't this a lovely pile of timber? Not the place I'd want to be if there was a fire.
Ironwood is near impervious to flame, my lord.
Is it?
May I introduce Lord Ramsay of House Bolton? Son of Roose Bolton. Although a bastard, Lord Ramsay has the full authority of the
Thank
Warden
you.
Of
no,
the...
That's enough. Who is this little boy?
I'll pick up it in this one.
Lord Ramsay, welcome to Ironwrath.
Aren't you the little lord? Lord Whitehall told me you were young, but this...
What about me?
Look at you.
A token for the new warden of the north.
Let me guess. Forrester Iron.
Carved by our most skilled craftsman.
Ironwood. Doesn't look like much.
Sell it, I guess.
Don't know what's so special about it.
No one can match our skill.
Is Whoa. That so?
Sell it, I mean, like, you know, he has confidence in this family that
Not
we can do our duty.
Bad. Lord Whitehill, can your lot do this?
Given enough time, we could learn.
Given enough time, you could do a great many things. But not this, apparently. Look at that. More foresters.
Lord Ramsay.
Come out where I can see you.
Rylan shouldn't have hide behind his mother. He caused too much attention to her.
We really must focus on the business at hand.
What is it you want, Lord Ramsay?
What do I want? Everything. Nothing. We'll see. First, let's see you bend the knee to my father. Lord Bolton, Warden of the North. Words are wind. Anyone can say.
I'll kneel just to please him, because Ramsay's very dangerous.
My lord.
Ha! That wasn't so hard now, was it?
I know it's very demeaning, but you have to be careful.
I don't care about your loyalty.
You have to please people who want their attention. Basically, that's Ramsay. He wants attention.
I've been supplying the Starks for centuries. Ships, shields, chamber pots. I expect you'll do the same for us. My father has promised as much to the king. You wouldn't want to make him a liar, would you? That wouldn't reflect well on me.
I want to say his father shouldn't worry.
You needn't worry. Your father will have what he needs.
That's a good little lord.
You can't trust her, Forrester. They murdered our men.
It was a Forrester squire who did it. One Whitehill soldier dead. One Bolt. Yet your man lived.
He was within his right. They killed his family.
His right? He killed a loyal soldier in my father's army. Then you welcomed me into your hall like a proper lord, hoping I wouldn't linger outside long enough to notice your pathetic little army. That sort of insolence from one of our loyal bannermen will not do. So I've come up with a solution that will benefit everyone. The Whitehills will be taking control of your Ironwood from this day forward.
What?
What?
The Ironwood is their livelihood, so you can't do that.
That is our livelihood.
Then you'd better well find another
fucking
job.
Fuck you.
You can't do that.
Why not? You know something the Whitehills don't? We are talking about
They'll
trees.
Ruin it.
You grow them, you cut them down.
They'll ruin it.
It can't be that difficult.
The Whitehills had ironwood, once, but now those hills are bare.
Hence the name, of course.
They know nothing of how to cultivate the forest.
Look at their sigil, my lord. A barren hill.
Do you want ironwood for the next 5 years? Or the next 50 generations.
All right, good. I'm going to see if anyone's going to buy it.
We'll try this. Lord Whitehill will take half of your ironwood.
Well, I mean, that's better than the whole thing.
But my lord,
half of something is better than the nothing you had before. To ensure there's no trouble, Lord Whitehill will install a garrison of 20 men within your walls.
At Ironwrath. That we cannot abide. Ethan.
They'll help maintain the king's
trouble,
peace.
Don't you think? Because how much the
and
White
make
Hills
sure there's no more
Foresters
trouble.
Hate each other.
This will cause more trouble, not less.
Not for me.
Great.
You have a man you trust?
My son, Griff.
Riff will lead the garrison.
You have no right. White Hills have no place here.
Lads, do make this visit worthwhile.
Please, Duncan.
This is why Ryla needs to be here as well. I mean, you know.
Look at this.
They number them, but still.
You're not frightened, are you?
Lord Ramsay, please.
And you? Are you Lord Eaton's older sister?
I'm his twin, my lord.
Oh, twins. Well, like the queen and her brother. Well, hopefully not just like the queen and her brother.
He's implying the incest.
I never had a sister.
Okay, always no, you're wanted. Not. You're not doing that.
Enough, Lord Snow.
I have an idea. You'll come with me. You can be my highborn ward.
Lord Ramsay, that's enough.
No, no, you're not taking her.
Do you like hunting?
Let her go.
Especially Talia, because she's so innocent.
She's quite pretty.
He preys on the
sister.
Innocent too easily.
We get along well.
Fuck you.
I suppose you can stay. Aren't you the bold lord?
Ethan! No!
But I don't want the bold lord.
I knew this was gonna happen, but it still bothers me.
Ethan! No! No! No!
Even though you did bend the knee. I think we've come to an understanding.
Lord Ethan!
I certainly feel better about all this.
What have you done?
However, the foresters need to keep their end of the bargain. Take the boy of your ward.
No!
Kill him.
Poor Ryan. Ryan, about this family. Oh my god, it's like another Starks again. Like, makes me feel so
lovely
bad.
Lovely meeting all of you. We'll have to do it again sometime.
Yeah, fuck you.
Somebody help him.
Fetch the maester quickly!
You brought this on yourself.
Mama!
Stop!
Don't let me!
Let it go!
Stop them!
Help me!
Ryan, please!
Stop it!
Bring them to Ryan! Do something!
Ethan?
My son.
God damn it. I knew it was coming, but still, it upsets me. Like, I hate it. Alright, so that was the first episode of Game of Thrones. I am going to be continuing this series, so
Ethan
hopefully
sacrificed
I'll have this
himself
up.
For us all. He saved Talia's life. He'll be remembered as Ethan the Brave.
This house needs a leader.
Lord Ethan named me Sentinel. I will lead this house.
My sister asked you to swear loyalty to her son, and you did it without flinching.
We can't let them hurt Ryan too. We have to stop them.
We do not stand alone. There are those who will fight for us. Those who hold House Forrester above all other loyalty.
Jon Snow!
Those who will not stop until Ethan is avenged. Until Ryan is home
again. So that's
Asher. Our house will not fall. We will be ready.
Nothing comes without a cost, my lady. Are you prepared for what might happen?
All right, let's see my choices. So, first one, 56% chose to save Bowen, which is good because my first playthrough, I didn't save him. I didn't know he was gonna die like that, so that was my bad. But I'm glad I saved him this one, even though he's an asshole. But next one, 68% chose loyalty to the king, which is smart. You play the favor for Cersei and the Lannisters so that they won't give you too much trouble. I believe that's the right thing to do. And, 17% took Eric's finger. So how many of you did, like, send him to the wall or saved him? I mean, gave him mercy. It's interesting. 64% picked Duncan as Sentinel. Alright, yeah, that seems fair. And, 57% met Ramsay in the Great Hall. Alright, so I guess I favor most of the decisions in this Let's Play. But, yeah. Alright, so that was episode 1, Iron from Ice. That ending still pisses me off, but yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. So I will have the next episode up soon, as I can play it. Yeah, so don't forget to subscribe and like and all that good stuff. I'll love your face, I promise. And also, if you are interested, you should check out my animation channel. It's youtube.com/justanoob. You should, you should check it out. I just uploaded a new animation that Achievement Hunter animated. Smoking Mushrooms is the title. So yeah, I'll have more animations out soon because I'm actually working on another one. It may or may not be a parody of some show. I will not say which one yet, but yeah. So I hope you guys enjoyed, and thank you again for watching. I will see you in the next episode. Bye!